Hey YouTube, how's it going? Well, today I'm going to install Bluetooth on my 2010 Streetglide. My dad has a 2013 and is just wanting a simple little Bluetooth setup to put in his bike. Well, I build a lot of custom stereos, in which if you've watched some of my other videos, I make them out of coolers, fiberglass, you name it. That's one that I've got similar like that. Well, they all use Bluetooth. I use something very simple on them. It's a Fusion Audio MS-BT100 Bluetooth module. It's waterproof, it's very simple, positive, ground, two RCAs, you're done. Connect your phone to it, you're good to go. But the problem is where to put it, what other setup do you want to use? Well, HogTunes makes a setup that goes where your air temperature does, right there. But I've heard a lot of people complain with that setup, the lens pops off, then you lose your waterproofing. The plastic nut in the back breaks off, then it falls out, and it's just a lot of little problems. Plus, this little bitty area, if you've got big fat fingers like I do, it's kind of hard to control the radio. Well, I've got just your typical Harley phone mount right here, and I used to use a little cable that would help me listen to my music. Well, on the HogTunes, they did have a good idea. They use a 90 degree RCA 3.5 auxiliary cable. Plug it in right there, tuck the cable back in behind here. Okay, the only issue, you need to be careful, make sure everything, so you don't end up cutting your wire. What I've got is this simple little piece right here. It's a 3.5 to a female RCA. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to take this Fusion Audio Bluetooth device, pull off the clamshell, and I'm going to mount it somewhere in the clamshell. That way it's easy to connect, it's covered from the elements, it's waterproof anyways, but it works. So I'm going to take the clamshell off, and if you need instructions on taking out the how to take the clamshell off, plenty of videos out there. I'm not going to do another one. Once I get the clamshell off, I'll kind of show where I'm going to put this Bluetooth module. I've got my clamshell off. Now, this is what my plans are at the moment, okay? I've got a Rockford Fosgate amp already installed, plus I did the antenna delete and ran it up under here. Well, okay, well, what I'm going to do is I've already got a positive and a ground coming to my antenna off the cigarette lighter. Basically, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take all of these piggybacks off and condense them with just one plug and get rid of the piggyback. So I've just got one plug on there. But while I'm doing that, I'm going to add in the positive and the negative for that, and then just plug them straight in there. Then I have my power. Anytime I turn the bike on, my Bluetooth comes on. Now, if you want to get it to where it doesn't come on unless your stereo's on, but let's be honest, who rides their bike without their stereo on anymore?
Okay, just so I can show what everybody's in this box, I'll just go ahead and open it up. Show you, like I say, it's pretty small, it's pretty simple, easy to use. I've used many of these. I've used them in boats, I've used them on cars, I've used them on coolers, I've used them on all kinds of different things. That's all it is. Comes with double-sided adhesive on the back, so you can just stick it inside the bike wherever you need it to. You can got roughly 3 feet of wire, so you mount it wherever you want. Power to ground, your RCAs. That's it. Short, sweet, to the point.
Okay, to make this a little bit easier, I'm going to pull my stereo out. You don't have to pull it all the way out, just enough to get it to slide back where you can run the cord for the auxiliary cable. Basically, you've got those two bolts right there, this plug, your antenna, and two more over there. Kind of a pain in the butt to reach, a little time consuming, but not that difficult. Once you undo those and undo those, it'll slide out. There's enough slack that you can pull it out, give you a gap in the front where you can run the cable through. Once you get those two bolts out, all you got to do is just slide the head unit back. You don't have to really unplug a whole lot more. That gives you all this room right here. Okay. What I'm going to do is I'm going to plug the 3.5 cable in here. Okay. So I did not have to cut anything or trim anything. Since this one's flat, I don't know how well you can see that. It just slides right under. Give it a little bit of play. Now all I gotta do is hook up the RCA in the back, which I've got them just right there at the moment. And I'll run them down and across over here, and I'll mount my Bluetooth. Okay, this is just a little bit of advice for whenever you go to pull out the stereo. If you don't have Allen wrenches with the ball ends, get them, because they help. I can't find mine, but if you have the ones with the ball end, there's actually a small hole right there that you can use to reach where these screws go right there. And if you've got the ball ends, it's very simple, very fast. It's one on both sides. Okay, as you can see, I got the RCAs hooked up. Run over here. Now all I'm gonna do, splice them into here. And I am gonna mount the Bluetooth module. Run it around and mount it up here. A little bit better spot to mount the Bluetooth module. It's this little square area right up here next to your speedometer. But to get it up there, you're gonna have to take off this little piece right here. All I'm gonna do is take a pair of side cutters, trim that off. Now you can take it, file it down, make it look a little bit prettier, but it's gonna be inside your fairing. Like that, put the double-sided adhesive, trimmed it off, it's in there. I just took the excess wire, tucked it right there. Now I'm gonna hook up the power in the ground. Okay, this is what I've done so far. Your center post right here is going to be your positive on your cigarette lighter. Take that, in which I've got the power antenna, so I've got that power wire, and then this is the wire that goes to my Bluetooth. Basically, I put them in all three of them, tie them in, solder them, and twist them, whatever you got to do, crimp them in here. But what I'm also going to do, because I don't want to take any chances on something popping loose and arcing, take a piece of heat shrink and get one that just fits over that connector, and that way it keeps you, it gets everything covered, so you don't have to worry about other issues. Plus, this is a heat shrink connector. Okay, everything's heat shrinked in, wired up, ready to go. All right, turn the bike on, plugs in, auxiliary's running, okay. Come over here to the phone, go down to Bluetooth. Okay, I don't know if you could hear it, but makes a little sound whenever it kicks on. Now, basically, let's find some music. All right, I had to find some good music, so. Now, that's all there is to it. Like I say, I'm only at the back of my backyard, and you can tell it still plays really good. So, and if I want to, very easy, very simple, very quick install. Like I say, if you're going down the road, instead of having to reach up here to the hog tunes while you're going down the road, you can just...
Don't need no five-star reservations.
Now if you want to change songs, all your controls right there. Or on the side, however you want to do it. Or let's say you want Pandora, which is the whole reason my dad wants it. Bluetooth your Pandora through it. So, that's pretty much all the difficulty to this install. Run your power and your ground through your cigarette lighter, which runs through your accessory. Put your Bluetooth up there, route your wiring up there out of the way, put your clamshell back on, you're done. Yeah. Alright, well, it's done. Everything's installed, clamshell's on. Only managed to lose one of my fairing bolts this time, somewhere in the floor, I don't know. So, I hope this helps you out. If you have any questions or anything, feel free, put in the comments. I will gladly answer them. If you have any suggestions, any other ideas, something else that works for you, let me know. I can add it into the video. But I hope this helps, and enjoy your ride, and be safe. Keep your rubber side down.